Heavy drums here, adding to the energy at halftime in the Bronx. It's 31-27. The visiting Fordham Rams leading the Jaspers. Now we're joined by a Jasper Gray. Russ, so good to have you here with us. When we talk Battle of the Bronx and you think back on your days playing, what comes to mind?
My senior year, class of 92, it was the shot heard around the world. Kyrie Wilson hit a shot at half court at Rose Hill Gym for us to win that game. And, you know, that was a great thrill, a great experience, and I still remember it to this day like it happened yesterday.
I can gather it still gives you a little bit of chills just talking about that. What is it about this rivalry? It goes back to the early 1900s. Why, when these two get together, you're seeing it already here, some of the chippiness, why is it so intense?
It's the proximity, you know, where the schools are. You know, it's the pageantry of the Bronx, it's the Battle of the Bronx. And, you know, it's stuff is passed down from parents to, you know, uncles, nieces, nephews, or what have you. So it's always been a great experience, and it's good to have people, you know, have a live audience like we have now, you know, post-COVID. So, you know, yeah, it's a great thing.
You look around the crowd here, there are so many people that played at Manhattan, played at Fordham, play at the local parks. We're talking with Smooth earlier, and he's just letting me know so many local basketball legends around here. After you win or lose this game, does this give you sort of like a bragging right into the summer until next season?
Absolutely, it absolutely does. Yeah, it propels you to the next level. When you gotta win this game. Yep. If you lose any game, you know, but you gotta win this game. This is the game you have to win for bragging rights. Bragging rights. Absolutely.
Now, I know you're at a lot of Manhattan games. You watch this team a lot. Looking at this first half, what do you like? What do you want to see the Jaspers do a little bit more of in the second half?
Keep the tempo going, the pace going. Play with that intensity. You know, vibe off of the crowd. You know, now we have live people in the stands. So vibe off the crowd. You know, just execute on defense. You got to, you know, play the defense. Defense wins championships, I believe. So keep defending, and we got to make sure we got to win this game. You got to win this game today here against Fordham. Got to win it.
And now, last thing, I got to ask you about my broadcast partner, Chris Smooth Williams. Uh-huh. He tells us all these stories about his playing days. He's always hyping himself up.
Yep.
What are your memories of Smooth on the court?
Chris was a fierce competitor, a leader. This guy was a leader among men, and he's one of the most unselfish players and unselfish people that I've ever been around. So that's, you know, and hopefully Chris is going to pay me on this by me saying that. So.
You just forgot the tagline, positive energy is a gift. Come on, Chris.
Absolutely. That's Chris, and that's Chris Smooth Williams. That's
and
right.
And that's legit. If you've never met the guy, it's not an act. He is that way 24-7.
No
Russ,
doubt.
Always a pleasure, man.
Always. Thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks so much.
Appreciate you.
We're back with more after this timeout.
Okay.